Welcome back. In today's tutorial, we're going to calculate the percent change using Desmos. We're going to begin by creating a function called f, and then f is going to receive two inputs. The first input is going to be the original value, so I'm going to use x underscore original. And the second input is going to be the new value, so I'm going to call that x underscore new. And I'm going to set that equal to the expression that we use to calculate the percent change. So that's going to be the difference of the new and original values. So x underscore new minus x underscore original. And we're going to divide that by the original value, which is x underscore original. And then to make this a percentage, we're going to multiply everything by 100. All right, now let's go ahead and actually use this function. So the name of the function is f, and let's say we started off with, let's say, $5, and then that $5 was increased to $7, so it was increased by 2. So we see here that the percent change is 40%. Let's take a look at another example. Again, let's use function f. Let's say that the original value was 12, and then the new value is 23, and here we see that the percent change is 91.666% repeating. And then let's do another one here, and let's actually make this one showing the percent change as a negative. So let's say we started off with 89, and then we went down to 30. So here we see that the percent change is negative 66.29 etc. percent. And let's do one other thing. Let's use a round function here, and with that round function, let's use the function that we're working with, and let's go up here and just copy it. So let's copy that, place it here, so we want that calculation to happen. And with that calculation, it's all inside the round function, and we want it to round to two decimal points or two decimal places. So we see here that this turns out to be a negative 66.29%. Let's clean this up a bit, and let's do one other thing. Let's go ahead and give this function here a name. Let's call this function y underscore change, or y subscript change, and set that equal to the function. So that means we can copy this here and put that in place of what we have here. So now we see that nothing changed, because y underscore change is the same thing as this function. But now we have something that's allowing us to do the rounding every time. So let's go back and redo a few of those examples. One of the examples was starting off with 5 and then increasing to 7. We see that it stayed at 40. The other one we did was 12 increasing to 23. And we see that's 91.67%. Again, this here has the rounding. Let's do a new one that we didn't do before. And let's put in here 50 and then increasing to 144, and then we see that there is an increase of 188%. And then let's put in the last one that we just had, and that one there was 89, 30, where we started with the original value was 89, the new value was 30, and because we went down, or the difference here is negative, we have a negative percentage here showing negative 66.29%. Alright, well, that sums up this tutorial by Spell & Math Tutorials. Thank you for watching, and if you like it, please like it.